and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a more basic makeup tutorial. I was trying to combine the words basic and makeup, that doesn't work. Basic makeup tutorial for you. Specifically, I wanted to show you the part of my makeup that I usually skip in my other tutorials. Like, usually I go from, like, you know, finishing part of the eye look to the next shot and my foundation and concealer and powder is done. Just because I feel like, you know, it's the same thing every single time. To show it in every single tutorial, I feel like it would just get boring to keep repeating that, basically. And also, well, when I focus on an eye look, the tutorial already tends to be pretty long and I don't think anyone would want to see half an hour of makeup. Long story short, I feel like if I were to show my face base, the tutorial would just get way too long. So I figured I'd just do a separate tutorial on it. So what the plan is, I'm basically going to show you all these steps in my foundation routine, from like a very basic natural look to a more medium coverage look, and then lastly this complete full coverage look. So let's get on to it. First off, the very basic look, like basically every step of the whole way that I take to a full face look are steps that I can also just stop at. So the very first step that I do for a full face look is just a little bit of concealer around my eye area. But on a working day I just leave it at that. I already did it on this eye. And for a working day I just leave it at this, because as you can tell it's just a little bit brighter and a little bit, I don't know, like you look a little bit more awake and fresh-faced. Because even if I've slept perfectly fine, like I usually sleep perfectly fine, but I always have a little bit of darkness below my eyes anyway. So I just like to mask that a little. I'm using the Instant Awake by Catrice. Everything I've used will be below in the video, as always. Below the video in the description, yeah. But yeah, I just use Catrice because it's very affordable. I mean, it's a budget brand and it's also, for my skin at least, it works really well. But what I do for this step, whether it be as a base for a full face look or if I'm just wearing it on its own, is I only apply this concealer like where it is actually dark. And what I like about this particular one is it looks really, really natural, basically. As you can tell on the other side, once you blend it out, it doesn't look as if you're actually wearing concealer. It just looks as if you're, you know, just one of those people who have really, really bright and nice skin underneath their eyes. It doesn't look overly bright. It doesn't look, you know, like you're wearing foundation, concealer. It doesn't look like you're wearing any kind of makeup. And that's what I like about it, especially for a daily wear thing as well. You know, just look a little bit more fresh without actually having to do a full look, because otherwise, like, if you use a really high coverage concealer, then you'll have really bright under eyes and nothing else. And with this, you just look natural. Then step number two is just concealing some spots where I'm a little bit more red. For that, I just use a concealer that has a higher coverage than the other one, but is pretty much the same color as my skin. How did I almost forget that shit? Anyway, but just, you know, keep it sort of centered around only the areas where I feel like I need it. I don't want this all over the place. Now, obviously, you don't need to apply it at the exact same spots that I did. That's just where I have more redness in my skin. But, you know, that's just basically the general idea. Just apply it wherever you have a little bit more redness in your skin. For me, that's my cheeks and the bridge of my nose, and also a little bit above my nose and also my chin. That's quite a lot, really. But yeah, it just depends. Like, and if you only have a little bit of redness, like around your nose, then obviously only apply it there. Like, you just gotta cater every step of this entire process to your own face. And as you can see, that this leaves us with a sort of my skin but better result. Like, it's just a bit more even, but you can still see some, like, unevenness in color and texture. You can still see natural shadows, like you don't get that whole, like, full coverage, flat-faced effect. So you can still get away without, like, even using blush or contour or bronzer or whatever. Like, it just looks fine like this. Usually, I stop at this step if I'm just planning on wearing a little bit of eyeshadow and mascara and then call it a day and just go grocery shopping or whatever. So like the days when I want to like look a little bit more fancy but still don't want to go all out with makeup. So yeah, that's basically step two. Now, there's also of course days when I do want a full coverage layer, in which case I at this point apply a foundation. And really at this point you've already camouflaged underneath the eyes so that looks nice and bright. You've already camouflaged the areas where there's more redness, so the entire like color of your skin is already pretty even at this point. So really all that's left to do is just apply a little bit of foundation to get a full coverage flawless base. It's actually really, you know, I don't know, like I feel like adding more thinner layers rather than one really thick layer of foundation just feels a lot more comfortable. So yeah, let's just apply that. This particular foundation I'm using, by the way, is the Catrice HD Liquid Coverage Foundation, which, you know, like it's not an extremely high coverage foundation on its own. It's decent coverage. It's, I would say, medium coverage. But I don't know, like it's actually, I feel like, I think that's actually what I like about it so much, just because if you apply a really thin layer of it, it just looks really, really nice and natural. Again, I just tend to go for natural. Especially because I feel for daily life, like it might look beautiful on camera if you have like a full-on flawless face base and all, but to be fair, in real life, I only do that on people when it's for a photo shoot. That kind of makeup, because again, on camera it looks great, but in person it does look a bit cakey. So yeah, and I just really prefer to just have my makeup actually look good in person rather than just on camera. Also, I feel like it's just more useful to show it to you that way, because obviously if you're going to like recreate one of my tutorials, you're probably going to want to wear it outside and not just take pictures, probably. Then lastly, I usually want the under eye area to be a little bit more bright. I've already done it on this side, so I'm going to use another concealer for that. It's nearly empty. I should have planned this better. I think I have a spare one somewhere. Anyway, it's the same concealer that I used on my redness on my face, but then a paler shade. Because I do want a little bit more coverage to really have it a nice highlight, but you know, I don't want a really extremely bright color. Sometimes I have these moments that I just can't talk. But anyway. Yeah, it just depends on what you like on your face, of course. But personally, I like to use a shade underneath my eyes that's just a little bit paler than my actual skin color. Nothing too extreme, though, because I personally don't really like the really, really bright under eye look on myself. But yeah. I'm just spreading it out in a bit of a triangle shape, so I do get it. Nice brightening effect. Then, lastly, it's time for powder. Around my eye area, I actually prefer to use a loose powder, and I do that with a smaller brush and just really pat it in there. Because I feel like a loose powder has less of a tendency to accentuate lines. And as most people, I do actually have some fine lines underneath my eyes. And I would like to blur them a little and not accentuate them, obviously. And for the rest of the face, I'm going to use a compact powder. The only reason I use a compact for the rest of the face is simply because my loose powder is a lot more expensive than the compact. And I'm a cheapskate, so I prefer for the rest of my face to just use this because it works just as well. But anyway, first off, I'm just using a small brush to go next to my nose because it's a tinier area. And I also use this brush to really pat it into the areas on my face that get oily the quickest. I just really feel like the extra layer of powder there really helps to make my skin go oily a little less quickly. I have oily skin, so keep that in mind. If you have dry skin, then obviously you might want to apply a little bit less. And then for the rest of the face, a bigger brush, because obviously I don't want to do my entire face with a small brush, because I'm way too hasty for that. And I just make sure that I just blend everything out nicely so I don't have weird patches of powder just sitting about. Now, I'm also going to show you contour and blush and highlight, because why not while we're here anyway. These are really the steps that I usually skip in a makeup tutorial. Phone, shut up. that I usually skip in a makeup tutorial simply because I usually focus a lot on the eye look then, and then I just don't feel like I also have time to really focus on the face, otherwise all my tutorials would be 12 hours long. So yeah, I'm just going to show you in this video as well. I'm just going to use one palette. This is actually also by Catrice. This video is not sponsored by Catrice, but I'm a cheapskate. Their products work well on my face, and why would I buy something more expensive if cheap stuff just works well? But anyway, I'm just going to use, and I'm using a palette because I'm lazy and this contains everything I need. That too. But anyway, contour first. I like to use a fan brush. One of those really large fluff hair ones. And I'm the sort of person who usually does her contour a bit like a weirdly located bronzer, really. Like, I blend it out quite a lot. Like so. Just so it looks, you know, just really nice and smooth. And then around my temples as well. Just so it's both a bronzer and a contour. Just saves time, I feel. And a bit around my jawline. Basically everywhere where I want just a little bit more sharpness or shadow. And what I like about the fan brush is because it is so thin, if you're light-handed, you can also immediately use it for your nose, so you don't have to grab a different brush for that. Which is also very nice. Also applied a little bit below my lower lip, by the way, just to make it look fuller. Then blush. I always apply it to the apples of my cheeks and then just sort of dab it out onto the cheekbone and into the contour. And I always dab, I never rub, I always dab it on and basically pat it really quick. Just because with some foundations you can actually risk moving the foundation around if you rub over it with a different brush. Which I don't want to risk, obviously. So I just dab it around so I'm sure that I don't damage the foundation, concealer and whatever else at that point is underneath. And if you want to go for really natural, you can also put a little bit on the tip of your nose and on your chin just to bring back some color there. Then highlights. I go for a smaller brush for that. And I usually keep it at a C shape here. And then also a bit on the bridge of my nose, tip of my nose, cupid's bow. And then whatever's left goes on my chin. And then with some setting spray over top of it, the face base is actually done. And then we're done. I just finished it off with eyebrows and mascara and lipstick. Just, you know, to feel a little bit more complete. Also, what I wanted to mention, the setting spray that I used. I always use setting spray, especially whenever I've used a more cheap and more dense powder that looks more powdery. The liquidness of the setting spray, the moisture of the setting spray, just makes everything go a little bit more smooth, so you don't have that powdery look anymore. It just looks more natural and more complete. It just looks more soft, in my opinion. That is one thing, by the way, with the Catrice powder. I like the powder for my skin, but it does give me a little bit of a white cast, which also setting spray fixes. But if you have really dark skin, then it would probably make you look gray, so, you know, pick a product that actually works well for you. But anyway, other than that, yeah, that's it. So I hope the tutorial was useful to you. If you thought it was useful, or if you just enjoyed me talking about makeup, whatever. If you, for whatever reason, enjoyed this video, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my tutorials, amongst which the eye looks that I normally do, you can also subscribe to my YouTube channel if you'd like. Other than that, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!